up again. Wind me up, turn me on, and watch me cry for you. Lately, drinking warm red wine is all I want to do. I'd like to thank the men that raise the grapes way out in California, and I'm hoping this will be their biggest year. For scarlet water's all that's left to keep me hanging on.
Lori Morgan, Wind Me Up. We're doing Who Sings It Better. You're probably reading me right off. You probably know where I'm going with this, don't you, gang? Well, maybe you don't. Maybe you don't. We got two more here. One more and then the final one, okay? All right. Yeah, so who sings it better? Who do you think sings them songs better? Did you like Mel Street, Tanya Tucker, or the one you just heard, Lori Morgan? Well, here's another one. Son of a famous singer. His name is Robin Young. Robin Young did this song live because his daddy did it many years ago. Here's Robin Young's version of Wind Me Up.
Great job. Would you welcome Mr. Robin Young? There he is.
I tell you what, it's good to be here as a second generation to share the stage with the first generation. Yeah. Some of the great people are up here. But Karen was on that. Has anybody seen us on RFD TV here in the past few weeks? And I was just talking, Terry Chill works with Larry Black over here, and I said, you know, y'all showed us for 3 weeks, and then all of a sudden we got bumped, and they put an episode, a rerun of Old Time Gospel. And Sharon Colley, who's Biff Colley's daughter, got on Facebook. She said, Robin, are you a little perturbed with the Lord? And I said, not at all, but I figure everybody ought to already know the Lord. I need some damn exposure, so let's get the second generation back up a little bit. But there's a few more here. I want the people from England that are here. You know, we do have George the Fourth and George the Fifth are over here, since y'all are missing the Diamond Jubilee. We got some country royalty for you. Here's a song, an old Fair and Young song, because there ain't no new Fair and Young songs anymore.
Yeah.
something I got from YouTube. It sounds like his old man, and we apologize for the poor quality on that. Somebody took it on their cell phone, probably. But he does sound like his old man. We heard him sing it another time live. I think he sung it on Country's Family Reunion, and I don't have a copy of that. But that was Robin Young, the son of Farron Young. We go a long way, don't we, gang? Well, here it is, all right? You have to decide. Who sings it better, any of those folks who did pretty good song versions of their song? Or do you want to hear the master of it all? He's a member of the Country Music Hall of Fame. They called him the Singing Sheriff. Here he is with a song that he did the best. Nobody can top this one. Farron Young.
I'm the center of attention in this bar, 'cause I've got the biggest heartache of the year. And each night those swinging doors reach out for me and draw me in, 'cause they know each night that I'll come back to wine.
I think we got 100% agreement there. The Farron Young, the Singing Sheriff, did the best job of that one. He owned the song. He opened many of his live shows with that song, too. I know he did it in Branson because I have a copy of that. That's a great song. That's a great song. Just an up-tempo, you know, great song. Oh, Stu says his better half is not quite a honky-tonker, but she's learning. Six-string Sue is learning. We'll get her turned on to this country music yet, won't we? We've got a whole history of it here. Gang, that's the way that goes. About 10 minutes after the hour, hello to Lad Daphne out there in Halifax, who's joined the chat room, Internet Relay chat room, pound-iWebRadio via a Star Chat server. We just jumped in here for a little bit today, gang, and not going to do a whole lot. Just get in here every once in a while, say hi, and not make a big deal about it and all that stuff. On this day in 1954, on March 15th, 1954, CBS Television inaugurated its morning show. The host, none other than the man who would become the most trusted man in America, Walter Cronkite. Uncle Walter was called host, ringmaster, and coordinator in the network's attempt to compete against the already three-year-old Today Show on NBC. Cronkite was a nice host, but clearly out of his news element, and the show was a ratings disappointment. And then Jack Parr took over as host sometime later, and the show still didn't work. The program immediately following did work, however, and that show was Captain Kangaroo. 1964, Richard Burton and Elizabeth Taylor wed for the first time on this day. The couple wed in secret ceremonies in Montreal, Canada. In 1971, CBS Television made a major announcement saying that it was canceling the Ed Sullivan Show from its program lineup after 23 years on the network. The Sullivan Show, a Sunday night feature, presented everyone from the Beatles and Dancing Bears to a talking mouse named Topo Gigio, plus anyone and anything in between. It was the longest running show in television history at the time. The final show aired June 6, 1971. That's a little bit on Today in History. Hi to Six String Stu, Steve, Audiophile, Lad and Daphne in the chat room. Me, Dave, and if you're out there, I'd like to have you contact me. Dave@pioneersofcountry.com. Dave@pioneersofcountry.com. Click the shout out in your player window. You can send us something that way. Or just join the chat room. Have a lot of fun. Do it, because it's the cowboy
yes,
way.
Yes, I mean, you're quite a cook, all right.
Oh, gosh.
But did you ever, in your wildest dreams ever, think about using a recipe book?
Oh, well, no, I never saw the need for it.
I thought as much.
Yeah, and besides, I can't read.
What?
You can't read?
No, it's that alphabet.
Moosh.
Looks like a bunch of chickens scratching. A-M-J-Q.
Moosh.
Well, maybe you just never tried learning it the cowboy way.
A is for the antelope, B for buffalo, C is for the cowboy, D for the doggy slow.
E is for Eureka, F fool's gold, of course,
of course.
G is for Gene Autry, and H is for my horse. I is for the Indian, J for Jubilee, K for the state of Kansas, and L for Loco Wee.
Hey, I get it.
M is for Montana, N for the new frontier, O is for the Oregon Trail, and P for the pioneers.
I think I got the hang of it. Can I give it a try, boys?
Go ahead, side me.
Let's see, Q is for
a quick draw.
R for rodeo.
That's it.
S is for the sidekick.
Should have known.
And T for Texas.
Mo.
Yeah. U for the state of Utah. V's for varmint dance. W is for water.
What?
And X for the triple X ranch.
Where we used to live.
Y is for the yodel. Yodel-eedle-oo.
This is fun.
And Z's for the bucking bronco, they call the zebra dun.